Hey guys, it's Huff. I am back here and this is going to be my March makeup basket. The theme this month is Leprechaun Love because St. Paddy's Day. I have a lot of green stuff, basically. And I have stuff that doesn't fit the theme at all. Because, you know, some stuff just doesn't. So, I have already moisturised my face. But I am going to, one of the things I've put in this is my Mint Maniac Elf Lip Scrub, which obviously is green because it's mint. So I'm just going to... My lips probably really need that. It's more that smells like mint than tastes like mint. I'm just going to put some lip balm on. This is just the Carmex one I'm trying to use up. I think that's in my 20 by 2020 project. So for primer, I'm going to try this Lacura Photo Fit Spray Primer, which I've never tried before. The first lot of sprays was literally just air. That smells a bit like hairspray, like their setting spray does. It's humid here today. It's not as hot as it has been, but it's humid. As usual, there's a fan on over there. The household is noisy. It is a Sunday. I start at uni tomorrow. So I'm trying to get this and another video filmed today and hopefully edited. As you can see, I have a fairly nasty little face demon there, so I'm going to put some green corrector on. This is the Natio Complexion Corrector, which is not in my makeup basket. It was just happens to be green. Green corrector is what you use when you've got redness, which creates an optical illusion, which makes it look like it's not as red. It doesn't actually take away the redness. And they can be a little difficult to use sometimes. And as usual, I'm sweating like a beast. So for foundation, I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me Dewy and Smooth in... what colour is this? 115 Ivory. I'm also going to add in a couple of drops of the NYX Total Control. The Total Control is like really matte, and the Dewy and Smooth is not, and my skin is getting drier as I get older, so I kind of need the... dewiness to it, otherwise I just look shocking. The Dewy and Smooth is like quite liquidy as well. I mean, the NYX Total Control's liquidy. That's it, it's a drop foundation. And the Total Control is also a shade lighter. And I'm going to use my fake, I think this is one of my fake Real Techniques sponges. I'm actually a big fan of this Dewy and Smooth. The other Maybelline Fit Me, the Matte and Poreless one, looks horrendous on my skin. it's just too matte, whereas the Durian Smooth does not look so bad. I'm sure it could be full coverage if you build it up, but I tend to just put on a relatively light layer. The other thing with the Total Control is it sets down completely, whereas the Durian Smooth, I find, doesn't. Which means that it does transfer, which I really don't like very much. For concealer, I am using the Maybelline Fit Me. It's actually Fit Me month this month because I also have the powder in. This is in 05, which is ivory as well.
Hello,
so I'm just going to set the under eye with, I've actually put in this for this month, the artist selection one, but I literally have the smallest amount of the NYX HD left, so I'm going to use that first. Yes, I've literally got like two, maybe one or two applications of that left in there, so might as well use that first to get it out of the way. For the, mainly this part of my face where I need to blend on stuff, I'm going to use the Maybelline Fit Me powder in 115, which is... If I use too much powder, I'll just end up looking like a cakey mess. But, like, horrendous. And it's doing the same thing, like, right here, on my mouth. It hasn't done that before that I'm aware of. Not a happy camper. Okay, for my brows, I am going to use the Anastasia powder in caramel, or powder dew. I tend to kind of work between the two sides. I've actually hit pan in this last year. And over the top of that, I am going to put my Rimmel Brow This Way. And over the top of that, I'm going to put the Rimmel Brow This Way Styling Gel in Blonde. couple of hands that are just doing their own thing. For my contour today, I am going to use the NYX blush in Taupe. It's going to be super light-handed. Then for blush, I have in a couple of choices. I've got this Laura Mercier Golden Mosaic, which is supposed to be like illuminator, like bronzery type thing. But it works fine as a blush as well if you want like a golden type of blush, which seems to fit like the theme of leprechauns, like gold. The other one I have is the Physician's Formula Rosy Glow, which is what I'm going to use today. I picked Rosy Glow because gold kind of glows, and I don't know, it just made me think of Ireland. I have a bit of a rosy glow in the cheeks. And then for highlighter, I grabbed out this cheaty eyeshadow quaddy thing. I think this is supposed to be a blush on some people, because all the other ones have got blushes in them, but this one looks just looks like a highlighter. So I'm going to use it as a highlighter. And it also means I can use the shadows that are in it, because the rest of the shadows that I have picked are not exactly neutral, and they don't really have too many light neutrals in them for things like setting primer or anything like that. They're just really colourful, basically. It's actually a really nice highlighter. I like it. I've never used it before, so I like that. That's nice. Okay, so I am going to zoom in, and are we going to do my eyes? Okay, so for a base on my eyes, I'm going to use the Pro Primer in white. I used the nude one last month. I'm only putting on like a really small amount. I'm not using it to make eyeshadows pop or anything. It's more to just anchor the shadows. My eyebrows look terrible at the moment. I'm just going to take the matte shade right here. This is kind of like it's basically my skin tone, which is a good choice for setting down your primer. So one of the other eyeshadow palettes that I put in this time is this one from LA Colors. It's, you probably can't see because of the glare. It's called Brown Buzz. I really like these are like $2 palettes. There's some really interesting colors in them. And the quality is pretty good. Like, I've used way worse shadows than these ones. There aren't any mattes in there, but that's fine. So I'm going to start, I think, with this one here. The only thing is they are super powdery. there's a number of different palettes like this that you can get. There's just a plain neutral one, and a sort of purple one, and a smoky eye one. And I own them all the ones I could find. I don't know if they still make them, I think they've changed the format of them slightly. But for a low cost basic eyeshadow palette, they're actually really good. Yeah, there's always at least like one dud colour in one of these, but on the whole, I found that they're all pretty good. Use that as my transition colour. Now I'm going to go into this other one which I've picked up for this. This is called Forest from Anoxa. Anoxa is a brand that we have here in Australia. I'm going to take this green here. This is a baked eyeshadow. And go in the outer corner and into the crease. Blending brush, give that a bit of a blend. So that one is blending away far more than the cheap one. Anoxa is not necessarily the cheapest brand. That worked. I'm going to try the green out of this instead. This is Ivy Icon from Maybelline. I kind of don't understand this thing particularly. So I'm going to go back into this one, and I am going to go for, I think I'm going to go for this really dark green. It's got glitter in it, but with a pencil brush. that underneath the eye as well. Now I have three pigments. I have this pressed pigment from L'Oreal. This one is Emerald Lame, which is this greeny gold one. I have a Gold Digger from Glamadol Eyes, which is not really like gold. Going Green from Glamadol Eyes, which is more of a yellow, and that is actually the one I'm going to use on my mobile lid. I'm not going to use any setting spray or any glue. I'm just gonna put it on. Maybe I will use setting spray. Might change my mind here. Yeah, I think I might have to. I mean, it's alright if you want, like, super subtle, but do I look like subtle? Just using setting spray to dampen the brush. And this is why you dampen the brush. Or use a glitter glue. Coolio. I'm just going to take my blendy brush around the edge, because I don't want any super harsh lines. Take my big fluffy brush, because I've got the tiniest bit of fallout. Okay, so for eyeliner, to tight line, I have my Revlon Grow Luscious, which happens to be in a green package. This is the one that is called Onyx. I'm going to use that to tight line. For liquid eyeliner, I've got my Maybelline Master Graphic, which is just in black. It's like this, looks like a felt tip liner. It smells a bit like it too. It's not the blackest of black. Well, they went and looked great, right? Before I mess them up anymore. Gonna leave them alone. Dude, don't want to ruin that any further. Was quite what I was planning. Anyway, I am going to also as eyeliners, although I'm not using these today, I have Emerald City eyeliner, which is green, and the soft white BYS coal liner, which would be for the lower lash line, were I to use it, which, as I said, I'm not. I'm going to take a small brush and I'm going to go back into the shade I used as highlighter, which is one here. Just pop a little in the inner corner. And a little up under the eyebrow. Then I'm going to curl my lashes. And I'm going to use on the top lashes my organic wear from Physicians Formula, because it's in a green tube. I've initially used this before, so this is interesting. Yes, I have multiple mascaras open at the same time. This is the one that Tati used to rave about all the time. At the moment, I'm not really seeing why, because unimpressive would be the word. On my bottom lashes, I'm going to use my Clump Crusher. This one tends to not transfer. Most other ones, I've got black dots on my face. So for lip liner this month, I have my nude one back again, the L'Oreal. As usual, I have a choice of several different lip products, because you know, you've got to give yourself options. So I put in the Strictly Vinyl in Bad Seed, which is green. You've seen me wear this. It's just that it is super duper sticky. I put in the Wicked lipstick from NYX in the colour Trickery, which is olive green. I put in Foiled again from NYX Liquid Suede, which is orange. I put in Coral from Elf, which is why I picked it, because, you know, Elf, Leprechaun, which is a nice soft coral. I put in Ginger Sparkle. It's supposed to be a lip gloss, but it's got quite a bit of colour to it. And I put in Electroshock from Revlon, which is a duochromatic lip gloss that has green glitter in it. So I think I might go with that coral today. Which is a pretty light colour for me. It's not my normal type. And I'm going to top it with some Ginger Sparkle. So that is it for my makeup basket for March and my look for March. I might do another one next weekend and use some of the other colours that I have there. Except for my forehead, like everything from like about here down is fine, everything from here up is not fine. So if you want to see more from me, click the subscribe button, click the bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content, give me a thumbs up if you like makeup baskets and makeup looks, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya!